Here's the question. Pause and have a go, please. What mass of oxygen is needed to burn 110 grams of propane? This is propane here. It does give it in brackets. 110 grams. You probably haven't studied organic chemistry yet, unless you're revising this in year 12. It's not necessary that you should understand the chemistry here. To begin with, we make an equivalence between what we're given and asked. We're given information about this chemical, asked information about this chemical. We make an equivalence between these two using the numbers in the balanced equation. No number here, so it's taken to be 1 mole of this chemical reacts with 5 moles of this chemical. That allows me to write that 1 mole of C3H8 is equivalent to, or in this case requires, 5 mole of O2. Because I have been asked to give my answer in grams, and I've been given information in grams, I'm going to convert these to grams. Let's find out what a mole of C3H8 would weigh. Do this side, showing the working out clearly. C3H8 has got three C's, each contributing 12 to the relative molecular mass. It's 3 12s, 36, and 8 hydrogens, each contributing 1. So that gives us a total of 44. 1 mole of this chemical weighs 44 grams. 1 mole of oxygen, that will be twice 16 because the formula is O2. 1 mole of oxygen weighs 32 grams. Because we have 5 moles, one should be seen to multiply that by 5, and that's 160 grams altogether. 5 moles of oxygen is 160 grams of oxygen. I would look to see if these are related. If this, for example, is a factor of 110, and it clearly isn't. So what I'm going to do is work out what 1 gram of this requires by way of oxygen. I do that by dividing it by itself, in this case 44, and that gives me 1 gram of C3H8. In algebra, you must always do the same to both sides, so I divide this by 44. So that's 160 over 44 grams of O2. Now I can work out what any other number of grams would require. I multiply this by 110. That'll give me 110 grams of C3H8. What you do to one side, you must do to the other. So I'll multiply this by 110 as well. So that's 160 times 110 divided by 44. And that will give me the grams of oxygen required. Let's see what that comes out to be. So that's 160 multiplied by 110 divided by 44. That gives me exactly 400 grams of oxygen.